I would like to thank the organizers of Interest 2020 Virtual for the opportunity to present this work, which was looking at the prevalence and factors associated with common mental disorders among youth living with HIV compared to their uninfected peers from the Kenyan coast. Compared to adults living with HIV in Africa, data on the burden of common mental disorders like depression and anxiety among youth living with HIV remains limited in this setting. Therefore, we conducted a study at the Kenyan coast, which had a threefold objective. Number one was to estimate the prevalence of depressive and anxiety symptoms. For this, we used PHQ-9 and GAD-7, which have been locally validated and were administered via ACASI. Number two was to investigate HIV status as an independent predictor of CMDs. Lastly, we wanted to look at the socio-demographic, psychosocial, and HIV-related factors associated with CMDs, particularly in youth living with HIV. This was a cross-sectional study conducted in Kilifi and Mombasa counties at the Kenyan coast. Participants were young people 18 to 24 years old, 406 living with HIV, and a similar number of HIV-uninfected youth. We used logistic regression modeling for the main analysis. As shown in this figure, we found significant differences between young people living with HIV compared to their uninfected peers in terms of the prevalence of CMDs. Being HIV positive was significantly associated with higher odds of CMD comorbidity, depressive symptoms, but not anxiety symptoms. Negative life events, HIV-related stigma, and low ART adherence were significantly associated with higher odds of CMDs. On the other hand, higher social support and better quality of life were significantly associated with lower odds of these CMDs. In summary, in this setting, we found significantly high prevalence of CMDs among youth living with HIV compared to their uninfected peers. Therefore, there's a need to routinely screen for these CMDs at the HIV clinics offering services to these youth. There's also an urgent need to start testing interventions that seek to address CMDs, particularly in youth living with HIV. We cannot ignore the high depressive symptoms we observe among HIV-uninfected youth of 12%. Therefore, there's a need to further understand the drivers of this relatively high prevalence. HIV anti-stigma campaigns and programs that seek to improve adherence among HIV infected youth are recommended to improving their mental health. Lastly, interventions that target to strengthen the social support and improve the quality of life of youth living with HIV may be beneficial to their mental health.